Hi, this is part two of our publisher and token node. Well, we finished our tokener, and now we will need a node that receives the messages our token sends. Good. So I've set up a structure here. Same as before, we've got a main method, and additionally, we've got a chat callback method. And we've got the same header files we used in our token class. The usual one here, ros.h, and because we are working with messages, we've got our messages included too. Good. Let's start with our chatter callback function. Our chatter callback function will be only one line, and it will print the line or the message sent in the parameter here. So we can use ros.info again. Remember, ros.info works exactly like printf. So you can write I heard, for example, and now we can give out, print the message number. Good. And now that's message data dot OC string. There we are. You can use autocomplete here too. Good. And that's our chatter callback function. To use our chatter callback function, we have to go to our main method, and the first thing we have to do is, like in our talker, we want to initialize our node. So let's do this, ros init argc, argv, not important here for the moment, and then the node we will call, give the name listener. Argc and argv are the arguments of our main method. Good. What we need is a node handle, and this will be called n, and we will need our subscriber. Remember, here we use the publisher, and here, obviously, we want to subscribe something, so we will use a subscriber. There we are. Call it sub, and this will be n dot subscribe. Give it a takes the topic name 1000, sorry. This 1000 means because if it subscribes more messages than it can receive, then it will buffer 1000 messages until it will start deleting these messages, and then our function we just defined up here, chatter callback. There we are. Really easy, more or less. And last thing, we've got a ros spin. This ros spin spins or loops so long until our ros ok is false. And remember, our ros ok is false when either you press Ctrl C or a ROS shutdown has been sent by other node. But most likely is that Ctrl C has been pressed. Good. That's our listener. Our listener has been finished now, and now we can start compiling our two nodes. To do this, open a terminal window and change directory to your package. My package is called test1. And here we have to edit, this gedit, our cmakelist.txt, because we have to define our node names here. So take the line ros build and add executable, and we will give it the name listener. And this is in the folder source, listener.cpp. Exactly the same we've got here. And obviously we still need our talker, so it's talker, it's in our talker file is in the folder source, and then talker.cpp, and that's it. Save the file, close the window, and now. So let's have a look what happens if we start to compile our two nodes now. Type make in your terminal window, and let's have a look what happens. Yes, we get two errors. I wanted to show you what happens if you do something wrong. In our toggle class, we defined here, we spelled node handler wrong. And you can get a pretty precise message. It says in line 11, node handle is not a member of ROS. So, you can have a look. You can press or type the first few letters, what you want, and then press control and space. And here it says node handle, node handler, and then you can spell it correctly. Remember to always save your file. And here we've got a small mistake. We didn't spell listener properly. Listener. There we are. Save. And if you type make now, let's see what happens. This looks pretty good. It says no errors. And we can type ROS make now. ROS make package name. And it says zero failures. Now let's start testing our two nodes we just wrote. So remember, always start your ROS core before you start running your nodes. Then you can type ROS run your package name followed by your node name, and here our node starts sending messages the whole time in our loop we just defined in our C++ program. So now we want to start our listener. Our listener will be able to receive these messages sent by our talker. So ROS run listener, and there we are. It gets all the messages sent by our talker. You can have a look what's happening in the background using rxgraph. And here we can see we've got our two nodes, or our three nodes, ROS out started by ROS core. And our talker, this one, is communicating with our listener, this one, over the topic chatter. The topic chatter we defined here. And here. Good. I hope you understood everything, and I showed you how to compensate a few errors if you misspell something. And thank you very much for your attention, and goodbye.